Welcome to Murugan. I'm Johan, Kannan at the wheel.
Hi guys.
And we are Ben and Marathi 800. We bring you automotive news all the week while driving around the streets of Mumbai. And that was busy one at that. So over to you, Kannan.
Hi guys. Today we have an interesting Volkswagen for you that we are going to feature at the end of the show. So stick to the end and do let us know about your comments on it down below.
Okay. I thought I would never say this, but that VW looks sexy as hell. Say stay subscribed, and we move on to the first news in hand, which is
we have the C300 Cabrio launch.
Oh,
and
top down motoring.
Yeah, and it's priced at 65.25, so
okay.
It's not terrible, but at the same time it definitely is overpriced.
Hey, come on, you can't judge overpricing in that segment. You kind of enjoy putting the top down, going 0 to 100 in, I think 6.2 seconds.
Yeah.
That's properly fast with that too.
370 nm and 255
bhp petrol engine.
See, the problem here is it's offered only in the petrol. So
okay,
the 2-liter BS6 compliant unit that they are giving, it's fast, but it's not that torquey diesel that you generally associate high-end cars in India with.
Okay.
So that is one reason why I said it's overpriced.
Okay. Maybe the rich people needed much more silent car than the talky car. Maybe that's the reason.
Probably.
But that's a good choice because I love the C300 Cabriolet, or even for that matter, any Mercedes Cabriolet with the white color and a red roof. I mean, that is an amazing combination. I mean, I think roofs are coming up in more colors too. That.
Yeah, so what basically Mercedes have done is they have introduced three new colors in the exterior lineup.
Okay.
And along with that, you get four different colors for the fabric roof.
And rich people really like customization on their cars.
That's true.
Yeah, so apart from that, they have taken care of the passenger and the driver, bringing some kind of an air pocket inside the car so as to
This has always been there in the Mercs, convertible Mercs. Basically,
okay,
what they do is they have a system designed wherein the wind noise due to the top down gets reduced. So, multiple functions like air curtains and, you know, air diffusers and deflectors all combined together to give you that good experience.
Of course we need that. I mean, you the owners will be taking their girlfriends out for dinner, wives for dinner with the whole hair and makeup. They don't want to get it destroyed.
Apart from hair and makeup, you also have the wind noise, which will make conversation pretty difficult inside the car. So that is also taken care of.
But in the smog-filled conditions of our winters, I wonder how much of us will drive it top-down, per se. That brings to the second hype product of the week, which is
Tata Harrier.
Yes, and it is, more news are tumbling out. I don't know whether the manufacturer is releasing it or people are leaking the specifications of the Harrier, but we are getting a hell lot of information about Harrier. So what do we have this week?
So basically, Harrier production has started and the first Harrier has rolled out the assembly line.
Okay.
It will be made in Pune,
okay,
Chakan plant.
Okay.
We also have news that it gets the Fiat sourced engine. They call it the Cryotech.
Okay.
It's a 2-liter unit found in the Jeep Compass.
Yeah, that's a really talky engine at that.
Engine is good. And we are also hearing reports that initially it would be a front wheel drive and there won't be automatic at launch. So maybe they are waiting for something to come up with.
Yeah, but they do need the automatic in that segment. I mean, that segment is defined by the automatic diesel combination. I am pretty sure by the way people have booked Creta and by the numbers it has sold, we have a huge potential in that segment of the market.
The segment is there, people are willing to put their money in, but it remains to be seen because the Harrier is pretty quirky looking. You either love it or hate it.
It kind of brings the big BRL onto the bonnet and then you have the headlamps down there.
It's a quirky design, no doubt. I'm not a fan of it personally, but I'm sure there will be, you know, like, it's not, I don't get pleased by every design out there.
Okay.
But there are definitely going to be buyers for the car.
But we are going to see more of it because even the Kia or whatever newer SUVs are coming, they are going to adopt some form of this design.
Absolutely.
So we are going to see more of it. But moving on,
we have the made in India Hyundai i20 getting 3 stars in the NQ cap test.
Okay, that's pretty okay-ish, I think.
Yeah,
so, not so good, not so bad too.
Yeah, it is definitely not good news, but the thing is, it's made in India and used in South Africa.
Okay.
So the issue here is, see, i20 now is a pretty old model.
Yeah.
So maybe 5 years ago it was capable of 5 stars.
Mm-hmm.
Today the relevant rating it got is 3 stars for adult,
okay,
2 stars for child.
Yeah.
Apart from that, the body shell was rated unstable and not capable of further loading.
Okay, okay. But I have a single concern here, which is when you compare it to Brezza, which almost you price i20 really well, but it reaches to the lower end of Brezza pretty easily.
Yeah. Or so, at times even matches it.
Yeah, at times even matches it. But Brezza is getting much more higher rating for that matter. And i20 is a premium hot hatch. So where do you see the value in
see,
that?
See, the same thing happened in Swift as well.
Uh-huh.
However, there are multiple factors. So what I think personally is that this rating and body type is absolutely non-correlated.
Okay. It's not because it's an SUV,
yeah,
and
definitely
not because it's a hatchback. That
because
okay,
a couple of years ago, if you remember, the Mercedes did a test of their Smart,
okay,
a two-seater car,
uh-huh,
head-on collision with an S-Class.
Okay.
And the protection offered to occupants in both the cars was identical.
Oh, that's
so
interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if somebody wants to make a safe car,
uh-huh,
they can do it. It's not about the technicalities not being there or simply being a difficult job.
Uh-huh. That's interesting.
It's doable,
uh-huh,
but the price point remains critical.
Yeah.
So
Indians are very sensitive to the prices they pay for their
exactly
cars. So that is a major concern for them. And that brings us to an interesting bit of news which comes up every time it's winter. Supreme Court starts banning cars,
yeah,
and then National Green Tribunal starts to come out saying smog is caused by cars. I mean, it only happens during Diwali.
This is basically a harebrained idea. I don't know who came up with it.
Yeah, even
but now, apart from the diesel, authorities are now after petrol cars as well. So
yeah,
if you have a 15-year-old petrol car
and a 10-year-old diesel car,
it's time to say bye-bye to them. And there is no exit option given to the buyers of these cars.
Exactly, exactly.
So that is the worst case. So
yeah,
apart from keeping the car, or forget keeping the car,
uh-huh,
you will, the RTO will not re-register the car after the time is up, say 15 years.
Okay.
And the worst case is you don't have any scrappage policy as well.
Yeah.
So what to do with that car?
Exactly. Our policy is lacking at either ends. We don't have a scrappage policy or a new car policy which can give benefits to the buyers scrapping the old cars.
Exactly.
At least that could have compensated this a little bit. This is, and a court cannot form a policy like that. The policy has to be formed by government. Otherwise, the court will be interfering in how government functions,
exactly,
which is not a good thing in our country. In these cases, we got to have a central policy more than a state policy, which differs from state to state.
Exactly. And the problem here is that whenever you see courts getting or coming up with such news,
uh-huh,
it's obvious that they don't have anything else to do, basically.
And that brings us to the last segment of the show, which we have the sexy Volkswagen Arteon. The details we have on that, I think it's as sexy as
yeah,
the car.
Yeah, it looks absolutely gorgeous. It has a good flowing design.
Okay.
You also get hint of what future Volkswagen cars would come up with.
Yeah.
It has those nice grills, you know,
yeah,
with
it's
basically borderless grill which goes into the
headlights. Yeah. It makes the car look much more wider than it actually is.
Exactly.
So even like the new Volkswagen, what was the
T-Cross.
Other T-Cross which
yeah,
we were discussing, that also kind of looked really good. I mean,
yeah,
Volkswagen is turning around with the design element, I think.
They have to identify themselves away from the Volkswagen scandal, basically,
which they got themselves into.
This is like what you call it. This could be a fitting upgrade to the Jetta and Passat line of things. So if you see the interiors, the engine options, the quality of materials used, a buyer will not consider paying a premium for this car.
Okay.
At the same time, it's not into the luxury car category, which would
okay
invoke an extra premium. So it's basically a middle car where you get the features and power of the higher end segment,
and even the looks for that matter.
Yeah, and the budget monetary wise of the lower segment.
Okay. that I think it fits in the VW value for money proposition right in. And if they have a combination of the T-Cross as well as this, you have a good lineup in your showrooms. And they have the Tiguan already in India, which is on the same platform.
Right.
And more products for Skoda too. So the platform as such is coming to India. Now it's up to Volkswagen whether to decide that this product is for India or not.
They are not yet clear on the policy of Volkswagen in India. As of now, they have given the reins over to Skoda. And before the BS6 norms come in, we have no new variant or engine launch.
They may not sell well, but they will have a robust lineup.
Yeah, you need to have that portfolio where there are options for a buyer. Doesn't matter you sell some cars, you don't sell some cars well.
Exactly.
But you should have the option to the buyer. Or at least have that halo product, because say today you have a Jetta owner, what will he upgrade to?
Especially the Jetta 2-liter TDI is like a
hoot
to drive.
And now you don't even get a Jetta, so there's no option of buying the same car as well.
I agree. As if the Arteon comes with 2-liter TDIs, twin turbo ones, single turbo ones, then 2-liter TSI. So 1.5 TSI as well. So it has the engine combinations for the market, and Volkswagen has the engines in India as well. So it is kind of a win-win situation for both. So what do you think? Volkswagen should bring it to India, should not bring it to India?
I would love to see CCM. More than an SUV guy, I love it when people are having or manufacturers are bringing in sedans, hatchbacks and all those cars. So that way I am a fan of this car. Whether or not it makes a financial sense, only
Volkswagen will. I agree to you on that completely. Sedans are still rocks the way it looks, much better looking than SUVs in my humble opinion.
Absolutely.
And with that thought, let's close the show. Please hit the subscribe button and write down the comments below whether you like the show, whether you like the Arteon which you just saw, and what do you cannot for sign up.
So that's it today for this show, guys.
Okay.
As usual, keep your eyes on the road, hands on the wheel, and drive safe. Ciao.